Hello everybody, this is Eric Rosebrock. I'm here with Robert Sweet, founder and drummer for Stryper.
Well, thank you, man. It's an honor.
You guys have been at it for 25 years.
Yes, I can't believe it, man. It's gone by just like that. So if you're 20 years old and you're loving it and you're out there playing, enjoy every minute of it because it goes by quick.
Awesome. So recently you transitioned to a new drum company.
Oh, yes, I did. D-Drum, the greatest company in the world. And I'm not just saying that to be nice. Yes, there are some D-Drum guys here. But I've never been treated this good, ever.
Awesome.
And on some of the big world tours we've had before, I've never had this type of, real special attention to custom drums.
Awesome.
And they have built me an incredibly beautiful striped kit. Now, by the way, if you got some pictures or footage of it earlier, you're seeing less than half.
Yes.
And so I'm excited when I get back home and I get a chance, I need to build some custom racks to set the drum up how it's supposed to be.
Cool.
There really should be much more up there. I think there's 4 kick drums total and 5 floor toms and 5 racks and 3 snares.
So now you have a 20-inch floor tom out there, right?
Yes, I do. And I also have a 22-inch also.
That's sweet.
Yeah, I love the square sizes, you know, the big ones. And the first night the first day, September 11th, when we played the House of Blues in Boston, I set up those 2 big floor toms, and people were like, why are those drums so big? And I said, well, wait till sound check. Hit them one time, I said, there's one of them, and okay.
They rock the
So
room,
I'm
right?
A big believer in big drums.
Cool.
But I did go with 20-inch kick drums, they're 20 by 20s, because it's the first time I ever playing small kick drums for me. And I've done 22 to 28.
28s, huh?
Yes. My first real drum set, and I don't even know how I did it looking back on it, was a 28-inch kick drum with a 16 by 16 rack with an 18 by 18 and 20 by 20 floor, and the rack tom was chained down to the bass drum, and I would stand up on it. Now, don't ask me how I got like this. It was like launching, you know, to hit a tom, but it looked really cool.
You also sit really low, because I sat on your kit up there, and it feels like I'm riding on a school bus or
kind
of,
yeah, or like a Harley or something.
Yeah, like a Harley, like a little boy.
I've always kind of sat low, I don't know, just kind of feels comfortable, I suppose.
Awesome.
But I took a casino chair and customized it, but I didn't get to finish. But I probably shouldn't say this, but the ultimate is I'm working on a chrome rocking chair.
Oh, wow.
Where I can rock and spin at the same time.
That would be cool.
Yeah, I just kind of love that, but with that kind of, I can't rock. So, I mean, you see me doing it every now and then, but the chair doesn't move. So if the chair moved, yes, it would be really nice.
Cool. So D-Drum is the first company that's ever actually painted the kit for you.
Yes.
Before, you've always had to do this yourself, correct?
I've always done it myself. You know, I had a big garage at one point, a warehouse where we would work on stuff, and I would just go down and say, for example, for the structure to hang the drums from, like the cymbals with on the chains,
yeah,
and with the 50 caliber machine gun bullets underneath, or some of the other stuff, I would go down and I would buy scaffolding, aluminum scaffolding, and stripe it. And it was actually really lightweight and really strong and really big and thick and very different. And I really enjoyed the different stuff. It's just my thing. But I never, ever had anyone paint me a kit. I always did it myself.
Cool.
And believe it or not, most of the time it was just a simple spray can and tape, put a clear on it, and everyone thought it was a custom thing out of a shop, and it was just me in my garage. But this is the first drum set where a company has believed in me enough to paint it for me and go through everything that they did to get it to me, and I absolutely love it. It sounds fantastic. It's beautiful looking, and I'm just thrilled.
Yeah, we recently interviewed Terry out at the drum room here, and he was just excited, like he was giggling like a little kid. He got to design your drum kit. So,
he's a wonderful guy. Rick's a wonderful guy. Everybody at D-Drum, and Dean for that matter, is wonderful, and I was ecstatic about it.
You recently said something about your chains on your cymbals. We put a call out there, our Facebook fans today, and asked them, you know, we told them we're going to interview you, and one of the questions we got back was, who designed your chains?
Oh, me.
So you were basically your own stage designer back in the day, right?
I was my own guy. I just did it all. You know, I went to a lot of, like, surplus military stores and, you know, a lot of, like, I don't know, just bizarre places to find stuff to get weird with, and I just loved the weird stuff, and most of it would be discovered on accident. Like I told the guys, I used to have a gong like I don't know, 3-4 feet in front of me and one in back of me, and I discovered by accident if you throw the mallet and hit the gong, it'll spin back and you'll be able to catch it.
No way.
And hang it on the floor. Yeah, because it's weighted on one
How
side.
How often did that work out for you?
Every single time, and I didn't know it would happen. I just, one day I was goofing off and I went like that and it came back at me and I caught it and went, wow.
I got to work that out.
Yeah. I also told him I felt bad. I threw it up in the air one time. It came down during the show and hit our guitar player on the head. Everyone thought it was part of the show. I was glad it didn't knock him out. But
awesome. You'd be up there playing guitar and playing drums at the same time, right?
Well, you know, we actually, my brother and I have talked about that. Maybe I'll get out and play guitar for a song and he'll get behind the drums and play drums.
Does he play?
Yeah, he does.
Very cool. Yeah. So you guys grew up in kind of a musical family?
We grew up in a musical family. My mom and dad were singers, and my dad was a bass player, and my sister's a singer, and of course my brother and I. And it's just always been around, you know. I never took any lessons or did anything like that, you know. But I, my brother and I started working together when I was in the sixth grade and he was in the third grade. And he played bass, a Fender bass bigger than him. And we entered a talent contest and won first place. I played drums standing up.
Wow. Nice.
I didn't even have a seat.
What kind of kit were you playing back in the day?
You know, gosh, what was it?
Sorry, do you
know? I want to say maybe Slingerland, an old Slingerland.
Wow.
But you're talking 19, what was it, 71, 80? I think 71. And it was a used kit. But I was just as ecstatic. Now, I'm 1,000 times more ecstatic now.
Oh, yeah.
So, you know, but...
So it took you a while to get up here to that kit you've always been looking for. You finally, found one that you really settled with. Huh?
It's bizarre. You know, I used to have the incredible drum sets where it was all custom stuff that was real trick. I did it myself, but I just... Even though I had good drum companies behind me, no one ever did for me what D-Drum has done. No one ever took the time to go, what do you want in the way that you want it? So when the guys actually told me they were painting it, I'd actually said, hey, you just want to like wrap it in a striped wrap, you know, I thought maybe to speed up the process. And they're all, no, we're going to paint it. We want to make sure it's okay for you, Mom. Well, that's kind of nice, I guess. I wasn't used to that.
It kind of helps to have good-rooted fans, too. You know,
it's a big-time blessing. Every drummer needs what I have with D-Drum and the guys there, honestly.
Very cool.
You know, we were looking
about
these a minute ago.
Yeah,
the other night, I thought I was blind. I had two pieces of wood fly off the sticks, and I got hit in both eyes.
I see that one right there.
And, you know, while I was playing, I got it out of my eyes. I don't... That stuff's all over the kit. There's drumstick dust everywhere.
Yeah, definitely. I almost need a can of air to carry around with you to get out of your hoops.
You know, that's a good idea. I've never done that.
I do it on the drum room.
We need
I carry it on. We need to do that, bro.
That's
that
great. Why have we not thought of that?
That's a little handheld Dyson, man. That'll square you right away. So your four toms will be ringing again.